Now, KSPW Weather with Carl Tormeyer.
All right, SkyCam 8 solar dad from 4,400 feet up looking across the Salinas Valley. That's what it looks like above the entire viewing area this morning, with low clouds covering all the valley areas and coastal areas. And we'll switch and take a look at the marine layer. And the marine layer has actually dropped in the last few hours down to 1,500 feet. Whether it will stay there is another question, but right now it's not quite as high as it was. We do expect the marine layer to decrease slowly over the next few days in terms of depth. Now, the last 8 hours with the low cloud tracker show those low clouds 8 hours ago in the infrared throughout all the valley areas. And as we progress to this morning's visual shot, we have the same story. Again, coastal areas and valley areas all covered with low clouds. Looks like yesterday and the day before and the day before that, and we can keep going. Let's get the bigger satellite picture and why the marine layer has been fairly deep and what we think is happening. Here's California, and there is a weak low pressure system been kind of hanging around Northern California, and you see it's moving slowly northward over the last 24 hours. And as it does, that will allow the marine layer to become more compressed and give its temperatures a chance to come up a few degrees. Microcast wind and low cloud model shows the low clouds down the valley this morning, pulls them back this afternoon to near the coast, covering up parts of Monterey Pacific Grove, and then back in again tonight, maybe not quite as far, definitely further than that. But the outlook is that the gradual trend will be for fewer low clouds, a shallower marine layer, and sunshine earlier in the day, although we'll still have night and morning low clouds. And by Monday morning, it should be better than it's been the last several days. But for today, high temperatures in the mid-60s in San Francisco, low 70s in the South Bay, Santa Clara Valley in the mid-70s at either end, and with warmer areas like Morgan Hill and the Coyote Valley, mid-80s. Salinas Valley, we'll start at 70 in Salinas and get up to 80 by the time we get to King City, and you have to get down to Bradley and the lakes before we see any low 90s today. Monterey Peninsula, largely in the upper 60s along the coast, maybe some mid-70s in Toro Park and Carmel Valley Village, and Santa Cruz County, low 70s along the beach and low 80s in the mountains. On the bay, pretty quiet out there, 1 to 4 feet on the surf. So let's go out to the beach here from high atop the Embassy Suites and Seaside. There's a guy out there, this went through a wave. So if he's 5 feet tall, that wave's 2.5 feet high. So that's about what we've got. Forecast then is basically no change from what we've seen the last several days. The low clouds will gradually burn off to near the coast by noontime. And then tonight, back again. Very similar, maybe not quite as far. And then tomorrow, we think we'll have an earlier burn off, and that means more sunshine in most areas. And right now, I think that's going to be some good news. That'll be the trend over the next few weeks, actually. And inland, see a slight rise of temperature ranges during the course of the week. These are high temperature ranges. And then along the coast, pretty much the same from day to day. It's really picking at gnats to try to come up with much difference right now. But okay, we only got a couple more weeks of this, and then our summer comes.
All right. Gray and gloomy until then, for the most part, right? All right. Thanks, Carl.